Hey everyone, this is the next video in the series about Spring Boot architecture that we are talking about. In the first video, we have talked about two things, that is starters and auto configuration. Right? These are the two components, magical components that makes life of every developer easy, right? So we are moving step by step. In this video, I'm going to talk about the Spring Boot starters, right? So let's go ahead and see that. What is this? Spring Boot starters reduces build dependencies, and Spring Boot auto configurator reduces the Spring configuration, right? So we are going to focus on this point, right? So in the previous video, I have explained to you, if you're going to create a typical Spring application without Spring Boot, you need to add many dependencies manually in your application and create the instances of those and include that into the context so that it can be included into the container, starter container. All right. So, but with Spring Boot, it makes the life of every developer easy by combining those dependencies. All right. So let me show you how it combines those dependencies, right? So this is the simple Spring Boot Hello World application that I have explained to you in the previous video, and this is the only dependency that I have added, right? So the second one, that is for the starter test, writing unit test and integration test, but for the business logic purpose, this is the dependency that we need. And by adding only this dependency, it has downloaded for me all these dependencies, right? So how it is doing all this, right? So let me show you that. So these are the some blocks, these are the name of the dependencies. Let me connect that for you. So this is the Spring Boot starter web that we have added in our application, right? So internally with this Spring Boot starter web, all these configurations are mentioned: Spring Boot starter, Spring Web, Spring Web MVC. This is the individual jar that is there, right? And this is Spring Boot starter. The boxes in green color, they are further a starter which contains other dependencies, right? So this starter contains the Spring Boot individual jar, right? And then again it contains the Spring Boot starter login jar. So it is, as name suggests, it is a starter for logging. So it contains the logging related stuffs like log4j, slf4j and others, right? So it further contains other dependencies. And it also contains the Spring Boot auto configure part, right? Now coming again, Spring Boot starter, it also contains the Spring Boot starter Tomcat, right? So you remember, we did not need to add the Tomcat dependency. It was embedded into this Spring Boot, right? So that is why it is embedded, because it is in the dependency section, right? So same, we have a Spring Boot starter JSON. For you remember, XML and JSON, they are there for the data interchange format, right? So Tomcat starter further contains Tomcat embedded core and Tomcat embedded login Julie and other dependencies, right? And similarly, Spring Boot starter JSON contains other JSON related things, right? Like JSON, JSON and other dependencies that are there, right? So these are the few blocks that I have shown you. There are many more. These are all the things in the same way that I have shown you. JSON, data bind, annotation API, accessor. So let me show you all of this. So if you want the list of all of this, how the version is coming and all those things, so let me take you to the directly Spring Boot website, the GitHub project that they have, where they have listed down when you add this dependencies, how many dependencies to download. So you can get all the list from there, right? So let me show you that. So Google is our best friend, right? So let me type here Spring Boot project and I am going to GitHub, right? So this is the thing. Google is, remember, you just Google it, Spring Boot project on this one. So you will get this link, Spring Boot, Spring projects, right? So this is a thing that we wanted. So there are many folders we are interested in Spring Boot project, right? So come here and inside this, you will see many things: Spring Boot actuator, auto configure, dependencies. For now, we are interested in Spring Boot starters, right? Now you will see a lot of this. Spring Boot Starter, ActiveMQ, Actuator, AMQP, AOP, Spring Starter Batch. So there are many more, right? So we should focus on what we are interested in, right? So coming down here, so let me show you the documentation little. Spring Boot Starters are a set of convenient dependency descriptor that you can include in your application. It is the same thing that I have explained to you. You get a one-stop shop for all the Spring and related technology that you need without having to hunt through sample code and copy-paste loads of dependency descriptors. For example, if you want to get started using Spring Data's API for connection with the database, include the Spring Boot Starter Data API and everything will be taken care by the Spring Boot itself, right? So these are all the starters that are created by the Spring team itself, but the Spring starters can be custom. They are created by other itself, right? So the Spring is providing that facility also. If you want to create your own starter for a technology that is not already in the standard library, they can list it here. Just send a pull request for this page, right? So if you have some library, you have some common functionality, you create a starter and raise the pull request, the team is going to include that into the proper list, right? So these are all those lists, right? So for now, we have added this dependency, right? Spring Boot Starter Web, right? So let me copy this and search here. So starter here, exact match we need this. So we have web service, web, webflux, WebSocket. We are interested in Spring Starter Web, right? So coming here, so this is the master version that they have, build.gradle version, right? So they have dependencies written like this, but it is more convenient to see the in XML form, right? So coming here, tags, so we are seeing the 2.2.4 version, and this is the same 2.2.4 version that we are using in our Spring Boot, right? So if I show you the version here, 2.2.4, right? So that is why I have here, so that we can match the version also, all right? So open this pom.xml. Right, so here we get all the things, right? So come here, dependency section, and you will see all the list. So let me increase the font here. Now you can see this clearly. It has Spring Boot Starter, right? It has Spring Boot Starter JSON, it has Spring Boot Starter Tomcat, it has starter validation, and from starter validation, it contains other dependencies also. We can exclude particular, right? So it is excluding that. So we have a Spring Framework, a Spring Web, we have a Spring Web MVC, right? So these are the individual dependencies that will be downloaded, right? So when you add that starter, right? So now it further includes the starter, right? So let me copy this and duplicate this and go back to this place. Right, coming here, so let me change the version right here so that we can see here 2.2.2.2.4. Now search for the Spring Boot Starter, right? So there are many starters, so but we want the exact match for that, right? So we are interested into this, so let me open this in the new tab and here pom.xml. Open this, so these are the just configuration. We need to jump to dependencies section, right? So it further contains the Spring Boot Auto Configure and Spring Boot Starter Logging section. It contains the Annotation API and Spring Core and YAML for the YAML processing, right? And it contains the Spring Boot Starter Logging, right? So I'm just showing you few of the things, other you can go ahead and see that, right? So logging section, if I open this also, I can go ahead and open this under starter logging. We have dependency section, logback, log4j to slf4j and jul to slf4j, right? So see, now it doesn't have any starter, so it is not going to look for any other starter, right? So these are the individual dependency. In the same way, you can explore this Spring Boot Starter JSON, Spring Boot Starter Tomcat and validation also. You will get all of those starter details right here. So now you know what are these starters, right? And let me show you one more thing. So these are, you can see, these are all the starter dependencies that it has downloaded, right? Starter test, starter Tomcat, validation, and web. So the details that we saw on the website on the GitHub project, if I want to show you right here, so it downloads those list of dependencies that it needs to download with the starter, right? So if I come here, show this in Explorer, you see it has downloaded this jar file. So come back one folder back, so you see it has downloaded all this and it is coming in .gradle, right? So if I have Gradle setup, this is how it downloads the dependencies from the Artifactory to your local system, right? So if I show you here, so it is the sources.jar, and if I come one step up, it is the pom.xml, right? Pom, you have to open this one, edit with it. Notepad++. So open this file, you will see all the details, right? So this is the pom.xml, right? So if I show you the dependency section, Spring Boot Starter, Spring Boot Starter JSON, Spring Boot Starter Tomcat, Starter Validation with the version detail, right? So you are getting all this detail, right? Version information also, you getting this, right? And in the same way, you can pick the particular starter right here. And if I show you the starter Tomcat right here, so open it and go to Explorer section and come back one folder up and open this one. This has this file .pom, open this in Notepad++, and you can see all the Tomcat related dependencies, Tomcat core, embedded, WebSocket, and this annotation, right? So by this, now you know from where all these dependencies are coming and what are the versions of all this, right? So this starter, I hope it makes now starters make more sense, right? So nothing is black box now. It is clear from where these are coming and where the individual dependencies configure, right? So in the next video, I'm going to explain you about the auto configuration part, right? Now we have starters which has bundle of dependencies, right? So how they are interacting together, right? So what is that is making these into action, right? So what is the auto configuration and how is that being done? So that I'll explain you in the next video. So all the previous and future video links are given in the description box of this video. Go ahead and check out that. And if there is any source code and anything else, I'm pushing that into GitHub. So any example source code, if it is there, I'm pushing that into this GitHub repository. You can come here and check out other videos, other source code and videos also, right? So I'll see you in the next video with the auto configuration part. Till then, take care. Bye bye.